Dr. Lakshmanan, can you come on video if it's possible for you?
Yeah, yes, a very good afternoon. I just kept it off because of this bandwidth, okay, but otherwise I'm available.
Okay, sir.
A very good afternoon.
Very good afternoon. Thank you.
Without any further delay, I welcome all the dignitaries here today on this platform. You know, let me introduce myself first. I am Dr. Vijay Gogoi. I am an associate professor in the Department of Psychiatry, LGBRIMH, Tejpur. So ours is an autonomous institute under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. I'm also the nodal officer of MEET LGBRIMH, as you can see on my background. This is an acronym for Mental Health Education and E-Training. It's an online training facility that we have created in 2018. And since then, we have been training individuals, not only health professionals, but also education materials, YouTube videos for the general masses. I'm also the nodal officer for telemedicine center from our institute. Now, we have been doing work in this field in digital area. We have the knowledge and we are still gaining knowledge and expertise on how to go about online training, especially for adults. And then simultaneously, we also have another initiative from our institute, which is Youth Wellness Hub for last 3-4 years. And Dr. Deeprut Chaudhary is the nodal officer there. During the pandemic, we all really struggled to maintain the wellness of our patients, of our clients. And then suddenly we came across MANAS app, which surprisingly is a combination of both our digital academy as well as Youth Wellness Hub, both working together. So MANAS app seems like an integration of both these initiatives of ours. So I'm not going to say anything about MANAS app right now because we have the very who has created MANAS app. The MANAS app is a brainchild of Dr. Ketaki Bapat, who is scientist F in the office of principal scientific advisor to the government of India. She has conceptualized and led the execution of this mission, MANAS Mitra mission. So without delay, I request Dr. Ketaki Bapat to say a few words, and I would request all the dignitaries to kindly limit their address to 3 or 4 minutes because we have a long way to go. Madam, over to you.
Yeah, thank you and congratulations. Let me congratulate formally, first of all, to your team and entire support by your director and institution and the our Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, C-DAC team. And because of this family, Ministry of Family, MHOW, we have actually coming together. They have actually denoted you and identified your institution and your people. And so we are connecting. We are also very happy that Dr. Atrey Ganguly, immense support is already there and she also gives new ideas. So all dignitaries are there. So I would really would like to thank them. And this is the concept. Actually, I will not go too much into detail. The whole idea, it started in my mind also that because of this pandemic and all, actually that way pandemic, I should say it is a blessing in disguise, that it actually compelled us to think beyond. And that's how we are actually very nicely, we are leveraging the infrastructure already there in our country and very wisely we are making it forward and towards the digital mental health as visioned by Honorary Prime Minister. I think we are taking baby steps to connect and all in other uncertain situations also. So this was the app. I am very grateful to our PSA and PMSTAC members that they have actually this what concept is from womb to tomb and completely wellness. Here what we are talking about the quality of life, how self only, that the competition as philosophy says, your competition is for you only. You are only your competitor and you are only your facilitator. So this is only a one job we have to do and how to raise the bar of your own quality in life. when you are actually with influenced by social fabric, social stress, I mean, so many stressors, so many well-wishers, friend, your circle, and all your thing. So how we should go about it? And what are the qualities you can imbibe in yourself? So this app is just few indicative qualities are there, and where the self-analysis can be done. Right now, only two modules for 15 to catering to two age groups we have done, but lot more to go. And let me also congratulate Tejpur. Actually, I remember Tejpur is, Tej is there in your name, this Tejpur, no? It means fast, it means ojas also. I remember one very good initiative done by Dr. Prabuddha Ganguly, who is the international IPR expert, and where that GI registration in one day, I think more than 100 or something he did for Muga weavers. And that happened only from University of Tejpur. So Tejpur has a lot of good initiatives. So today is also one of the this kind of a thing. So what we will look forward is that how should we take further, how we can strengthen our social fabric through different things, and how we can personify things. And our experts are all are there to suggest few words and all, and how we can inculcate the good practices. So I will stop here. I will wish all the very best, and we will take forward this kind of a thing. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. We would really like to, you know, collaborate with you and the other dignitaries to take wellness to the forefront. Now I request Dr. S. Sudarshan, who is the executive director of C-DAC, and who has a very rich R&D experience of 30 years around in IT. And he is involved in the development of the app from the very beginning. Sir, please address the gathering.
Sir, namaste. Good afternoon, and congratulations to Dr. Gagai and Dr. Duri for the time and bringing out the specific aspect of the synergy and similarity in thought process of digital and psychology more relevant during this COVID time. So to that extent, it is so nice, you know, wherever we are, we think alike. So that is extremely good. The humanity, you know, they say telepathy, all those things, you know, we can see it happening. That is very nice. And as you already mentioned, you know, Dr. Bapat from Office of PS and her entire team, they have been the backbone of this idea at the right time, because everything has a place and time, and it has come very nicely. So definitely it is wonderful to have it. And Dr. Ganguly has been supporting us all through, and she is present here. And thanks to Dr. Lakshmanan for joining. And the topic itself is very, very interesting. That's the only thing I would like to highlight in a minute. Creating a safe space for conversation. So when we talk of conversation, I personally believe we are healthy and comfortable when we are comfortable with the self, with oneself. Because if you have any reservation about my own body language or mental state, it impacts negatively everybody around. So the first and foremost is being able to be comfortable with the self, whatever is my condition. Both it is philosophically as well as, you know, from a medical perspective, that is something we have to keep in mind. And that is where these digital platforms give that freedom. Because I don't need another person to interact. I can be on my own and be comfortable with myself until the time I reach a level of confidence where I can interact with others. So it's in a very simple word, it is like bathroom singing. Till the time I'm comfortable, I don't want to come on stage. This is the kind of benefit a digital app gives. But the content is coming very rich from experts from NIMHANS, AFMC, and the names that are on the top of the game. They are the one who have designed the content. And we have just digitized and we are creating a platform. So to that extent, it is the right thing. And it is excellent that you also have a lot of initiatives from youth wellness to, you know, creating a safe space. And they need to be synergized. As Madam told already, we have to go a long way. And this is, you know, beginning of a very long joint journey. And with that, I'll just pause and thank my colleagues, Dr. Sarita, Karthika, and Sukeshini, who are all on this call. and they are doing a lot of back-end work along with you. And it has always been wonderful. I'm looking forward to hearing from the entire team led by Dr. Chaudhary, and then, you know, the discussions Dev Madam and Sen Gupta Ji and all. So looking forward for a wonderful next hour and a half to learn from all of you. And once you are comfortable self with the app and all, then, you know, we can converse among everyone. And then overall baseline will improve. That will put country and humanity on the right path. So with that, I thank everyone and I'll hand over it back to Dr. Dave. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for your brief, overall overview of what wellness is all about, how we should take care of ourselves first. Now, before we move ahead with the other dignitaries, because we are talking about Manas app, may I ask Youth Wellness Hub to kindly play a brief video about what Manas app is all about.
Thirteen percent of adolescents aged 13 to 17 years have experienced mental health problems. They face difficulty in handling uncertain situations and suffer from depression, anxiety, stress and substance abuse. In India, there is dearth of indigenous digital tools on mental wellness.
Our mental health is very important. In a sound mind is in a sound body. Iska उल्टा भी उतना ही सही है। जब हमारा मन चंगा होता है, स्वस्थ होता है, तो ही शरीर भी स्वस्थ रहता है।
An initiative by Office of the Principal Scientific Advisor, Government of India. Protect well-being of citizens. To promote and empower. Provide measures to aid mental wellness. Ensuring wellness of youth and specially designed for the age group of 15 to 35 years. MANAS, Mental Health Normalcy Augmentation System. One step towards making mental wellness more accessible and more attainable. Being developed with the technical expertise of C-DAC Bengaluru, domain expertise of NIMHANS Bengaluru and AFMC Pune. MANAS is an indigenous app for mental wellness. MANAS is a comprehensive, scalable and secure national digital well-being platform. The unique features are well-researched interventions, evidence-based measures, personalized content dissipation, Indian language support, self-evaluation, improved daily life practices. Time Smart is about learning to convert one's personal goals in different life domains into smart plans and to move on to pursue them through smart actions. Deep Connect focuses on learning to recognize and amplify positivity in day-to-day interactions. Good sleep helps to become aware of their sleep patterns, habits and useful tips to deal with the stress and sleep better. Mindfulness is a way of paying attention to the present moment, provides tools to understand and practice mindfulness in an engaging and experiential way. Awareness programs, content integration and support from Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Ministry of Culture, Ministry of Tourism, Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. MANAS is continuously striving for mental well-being of all Indians. MANAS is conceptualized, mentored and continuously supported by Dr. K.T. Bapat. Under the guidance and encouragement from Dr. Madhuri Karnitkar, Professor K. Vijayaraghavan, Principal Scientific Advisor, Government of India. MANAS takes inspiration from India's West Bharat, Digital India, Rashtriya Kishore Swasthya Karyakram, Ayushman Bharat, Manodarpan Initiative, District Mental Health Program DMHP and Primary Health Care, PHC, Mardoshan Scheme of IT and National Health Mission. For strengthening national evidence based on mental health promotion.
हेलो
हेलो हाँ जी मुझे ना डेंगू हो गया मैं
फुल रिफंड चाहिए था
मेरा भाई gallery view. Okay, so that was in brief about what Manas app is, and surprisingly, the targeted age group matches with what we have been doing here in Youth Wellness Hub. So now moving forward, I would request Dr. Athriya Ganguly, who is a national professional officer from the Office of WHO India, and she is in mental health and substance use. Madam, you have been associated with so many webinars for this app. I would like you to address the gathering and also the audience.
Good afternoon, everybody. At the outset, many thanks to you, Dr. Gogoi and Dr. Theory, Dr. Bapat, Dr. Sudarshan, and other dignitaries for giving WHO an opportunity to be working for this cause. Definitely, this is something, you know, the need of the hour. With COVID around, we've seen how the digital technology can be optimized to reach out to an unreached, and also the need for having mental well-being is aptly highlighted. So taking from the topic of today's webinar, I would like to stress on three words or three phrases. First is mental health. As WHO defines mental health as a condition, and as where people are able to take care of their own stresses and at the same time be also productive to the society. So Manas app and the initiatives by LGB and other associated organizations are definitely in this regard. Second is we are talking about wellness. Now, in COVID, we've seen, you know, a very much paradigm shift in the approach, first, like from I to we. So if we take in illness, if we replace I of illness by we, then it becomes wellness. So that is one major thing we've seen for COVID. Also, I means I, myself, it has become we. So now we are all partnering. So COVID has shown us the effect of team. Team means together we achieve more. So this has been a great thing. Must congratulate all our partners for this. And thirdly, youth, of course. Youth is the backbone of our country. India has got the largest number of young population. So catering to their mental health, catering to, because health is not just physical health. It is physical, mental, psychosocial. So making them productive, thus contributing to the progress of the country. So many congratulations once again for this initiative, and I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am, for taking our time for this webinar. Now I would like to introduce Dr. Lakshman S., who is the mission director of National Health Mission Assam. And he's a medico by profession, and he has been really active in the field of mental health. Like, he has been sending medical officers, psychologists, social works for training in LGBRIMH, and he's really active in the area of mental health. Sir, I welcome you, and I would like you to address the gathering.
A very good afternoon to all respected panelists, Dr. Gogoi, Dr. Biori, Sri Sudarshan ji, Dr. Bapat, and all participants in the VC. First of all, I take this opportunity to thank and congratulate LGBRIMH for taking this initiative and such a beautiful acronym meet, very beautifully planned. And let me take this opportunity to thank you all. Coming straight to the point, when we are talking about mental health, what we find is that from the public health point of view, not institutional level management, but on the public health point of view, over a period of time when we are establishing and implementing national mental health program, what we find is that at the field level, we are coming across multiple cases where because of difficulties in transportation, we are unable to send many patients to one institute only, that is LGBRIMH. Now, the problem is, we could have treated them, we could have helped them even at home. But for treating a mentally affected person, we have to keep the family members also very, very actively involved in the treatment. And that is where probably this MANAS app, I think, to a great extent is going to help us. Because for all other general conditions, what will happen? If I am having hypertension, I'll take medicine myself. If I am having diabetes or some other thing, I am likely to take my medicines myself. But in mental health disorders, it would be slightly difficult for the patient to himself have the medications. Therefore, probably involving the family members or even a volunteer who can come and support would be of great importance. So this MANAS app, I think at some point of time would be an extended app where we can have a proxy member as well. That would be one suggestion from my side. Beyond that, what I understand is that in these kind of efforts, when we are trying to reach out maximum number of people, the initial phase itself, many a time faceless conversation is very helpful because people do have problems to come out very forward. I'm just telling what we are experiencing on field, that many people would be quite okay to tell that, okay, I'm having diabetes or I'm having hypertension or even to an extent I'm having some more serious disease, say cirrhosis or renal failure. But very, very few people will be comfortable or confident enough to come forward and tell that, okay, I'm having depression or I'm having mania or some sort of that kind of disease, even OCDs and smaller things. So maybe a faceless kind of app where it is much more confidential to get the data, get the proper advice will be definitely appreciated by people. What I'm looking forward from today's video conference is that how we are really going to make it public friendly, really accepted by public, utilized by public in a larger scale. I'm looking forward for valuable inputs from all the participants. Thank you so much. We'll be interacting again. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for your...
Sorry, you are mute.
Sorry.
You are... Now it is okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, sir. Thank you so much for your keen observations and letting us know the difficulties. I know when you keep working on the ground, there are a lot of difficulties that we face. And interestingly, sir, the thing that you just mentioned, we are already working on it. There are multi-institute collaborations are ongoing. And this digital technology is going to be a, you know, it is a long way ahead. And we are really moving forward in that direction. There are many initiatives which are still ongoing. Okay. I think our director, sir, somehow he lost connection. Is he trying? Is he here? Okay, till the time he joins, I request Dr. Deeptarup Chaudhary to take forward from here and, you know, move the webinar forward of what we mean by creating safe spaces for conversations around mental health and wellness among youths. So over to you, Deeptarup.
Thank you, Vijay, and good afternoon to all the respected dignitaries, my seniors, colleagues, friends who has joined. May I request the Hub team to put up the PPTs? So basically we are going to talk about creating safe space for conversation around mental health and wellness among youth. And I have a minor role to play because neither I look young or I am young in terms of the chronological age, but still I thought that as a coordinator before my younger colleagues come into the picture and take the session forward. I like to share some stories about the beginning of the journey of Youth Wellness Hub. And I have named this journey as In Pursuit of Wellness and Recipe, in Pursuit of Wellness Recipe, the journey together.
Sorry, Deeptarup, sorry to interrupt. Can you stop the screen share, please. Yes, I think we have our director sir here. We'll hear from our director sir first, and then we will go ahead with the discussion. Sorry to interrupt, Dr. Dipturu. Yeah.
Am I audible? Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir.
I'm so sorry that lost the power was there. So we offline. Good afternoon to everybody. So it's a great opportunity. And I'm immensely grateful to the panelists for this webinar. And I congratulate our team and LGB for arranging this. There's nothing much to say on this because all the experts are around, but there are a few mentions I have to make before I sign off, because this I thought is very, very important for us. Everything started with an experiment. In the beginning, we wanted a safe conversation about mental health, wellness, stigma, and all those matters. For this, we are looking around for informal, that means everyone can join in, a very unstructured space which is boundaryless. It should be unrestrained. The discussions there and the participation will be unrestrained, so it will be free flowing, and it has to be a neutral space because there's going to be no agenda for us. So ultimately, the concept came from our young team in LGB that we'll open up a place called the hub. It's a place like our general Adda in northeast and eastern side of from Bengal to Bihar and all northeast. We have a system of getting together and expressing ourselves in a very friendly, unrestrained, and informal manner. So I think that name stuck. And we said, okay, let us go ahead with this concept of Adda. But he wanted a civilized name and he called it a hub. I said, fine, go ahead. Then they were more specific of whom to call. Should it be youth only or somebody else? Then for some time, when they drifted around and said that, okay, youth is going to be the biggest investment in a sense that in future, they are going to be around for a long time. And the message which we pass along, we deliver here, the discussions that takes place in this space is going to carry forward very long distance. And there were wonders for first 2 years because they had communicated with agencies, they have communicated with university departments, they have communicated with schools, colleges, and the link was established in a very firm manner. I think Dipturu will be talking about it later in great details. Then, after that, this informal meeting kept on happening for quite some time. And once in a while, when I dropped in, I realized that, okay, this is a nice way of carrying forward a message to the mass. So when COVID happened, restrictions were in place, movements were restricted, and get-togethers were no more like before. So they have immediately switched to a digital platform. It kept on going on that manner in different ways. Dr. Biza will be there to explain about that. They have done a lot of exercise in it. After that, when this app came along, and in the beginning, we had a lot of talk about this. And when it came along to reality, then you have come to realize that, okay, this is something which is going to be of a great help to people. And the conversations that take place in this platform is going to be very, very useful. Though we have not yet had a formal feedback on this about our ventures, but I am very confident that very soon we are going to have a really useful use of this electronic domain, and that's going to take us places. So today is a day when we are here as listeners, and we are here to listen to the experiential and scientific informations, technical inputs from the experts. And I, with these words, I again sincerely express my gratitude to all of you, especially the dignitaries who have already addressed you all. Thank you so much. And please, I request Dr. Gogoi to take over from here and carry on with the program. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir, for always pushing us to cross our limits and go ahead with the new initiatives and helping us out in taking all our initiatives forward. Really appreciate your help. Now I request Diptarup to please continue with his topic. Diptarup, yes.
Yeah, thank you. So as I was telling you all that we have been in pursuit of a wellness recipe, and the pursuit has been together. Next slide. Yeah. So in this part, I'll start with my story. My training in clinical psychology from NIMHANS, especially positive psychology unit, and working as an university faculty in Bangalore for a long time provided me a unique learning opportunity to see how the mental health care space and the educational space could dialogue with each other, influence each other, and get influenced in turn. My joining LGBRIMH 7 years back and working as a clinical psychology consultant gave an opportunity to see close up how young people with mental health challenges struggle with their inner worlds, as well as many barriers they encountered in the external world. Despite the debilitating illness symptoms, significant stigma, hesitancy in seeking help, those brief encounters in clinical space made me believe that pursuit of wellness is as important a goal as recovery from illness. And every time I strongly felt a desire to be a magician, not a clinician, and turn back the clock for them and make that small change to create a butterfly effect in their lives, I felt I need the special recipe of wellness. So that's how the journey began. Next slide, please. So deciding the road was important as I was immersing myself to understand the cultural context and larger youth community and alongside appreciate their strengths and resilience. I got lucky to be a part of a team in the Institute which curated a month-long variety of programs to observe the World Mental Health Day in 2018. That year's theme was Young People and Mental Health in a Changing World, which inspired us to reach out to college campuses with interactive sensitization seminars, culminating into fun contests around youth mental health called Yuva Manmeet, literally speaking, Young Minds Gathering. With the promising outcomes of college outreach initiatives and the community's felt need for creating a new and unique space catering to youth mental health, focusing on prevention promotion, our respected director, sir, of LGBRIMH, during the valedictory program of the month-long initiative, formally declared the beginning of Youth Wellness Hub, which we fondly call just as Hub. It was thought of as a dedicated space for various activities geared towards promotion of mental health, as well as providing psychological care to distressed young people who hesitate to seek regular OPD services due to stigma and other barriers. The Hub thus emerged as a multidisciplinary center consisting primarily of students and a few designated staff members across various departments of the Institute, led by the Department of Clinical Psychology. Next slide, please. As we started our journey towards wellness, we found the first important ingredient of a recipe of wellness, and that is fun. So now stepping out of the clinic, March 2019, to overcome the challenge on the ground and brainstorm new ideas, an advisory committee was formed comprising of our members, principals, faculty members, local colleges, universities, and more importantly, student members of various institutes as advisors to the Hub, receiving inputs from the advisory committee members reviewing existing global research in youth mental health and critically evaluating the best practices in youth mental health and well-being initiatives, it was decided that the hub initiative needs to be conceptualized in a youth-centric, local, context-sensitive and unique way. Hub got an opportunity to practice it very soon when it was invited by Tejpur University to set up a stall with interactive exhibits on mental health and wellness for students to popularize it. Informal interaction over fun activities made us realize that the second important ingredient of a wellness recipe has to be adda, which our director sir has already mentioned, a conversation among equals, an informal conversation among equals, a term which entered Oxford Dictionary in 2004. Such is the power of adda. Next slide, please. So going into the nature, May 2019, so we soon discovered the healing power of nature and its rich biodiversity, something that is a gift for all of us staying in North especially. The idea that forests could be healers and that the youth could be dedicating their passion and energy for conservation of forests and much more than that was brought to us by Green Hub Tejpur, one of our partners since then. Through them, we got connected to so many communities of Northeast, realized the importance of community well-being. We found connection as another important ingredient of wellness recipe, which we earned through so many of friendships on the way till now. Next slide, please. So we celebrated our first birthday, 1 year of existence in 2019, November. We celebrated our first birthday with youth of Tejpur, organizing our first youth wellness festival, Yuvaman Meet. Our institute gifted Hub a renovated Assam-type bungalow with a homely feel around it, making it easy for us to create a youth-friendly, welcoming and safe space for all. You know, we are sitting in the bungalow right now as we are talking to you all, and you could see some of the photos at the back of mine, which is an ongoing exhibition of photos. As we celebrated together, we realized on the way that one size does not fit all when it comes to youth wellness and that we have to have multiple ways of wellness. That was another ingredient of our wellness recipe. Next slide. Holding on to hope during pandemic and hosting online programs and festivals. So the last two pandemic years were difficult for us. We initially felt that it is not possible for us to create the intimate experiential mediums of wellness, which we tried and found effective during the pre-pandemic days. However, by then, we were a big family with members looking up to us to create ways online, virtually, for the wellness activities and conversations. Since then, we have been courageous to try out new things online because for us, connecting and caring cannot stop. Not even the powerful COVID virus could do that. So another important ingredient, connection and care. So wellness, next slide, I'll end here. So as we went ahead, we felt that wellness is a journey together and not a destination. And it's not a foolproof final recipe, but it's a search for various ingredients as we go ahead. And so here we are negotiating our journey through offline and online mode. Thank you for listening to our story of the journey of the wellness. We hope that we find many more ingredients of wellness on the way as we go ahead together. And as I hand over the later part of the session to the Youth Wellness Hub team, I would also like to introduce them. So as you could see in Youth Wellness Hub, we have Toma, Promita, and Sucheta. They have been associated with Hub for the last 2, 3, 4 years, almost from the beginning of the Hub. They are currently doing their PhDs in clinical psychology. I also would like to welcome and introduce our colleagues, collaborators from Tejpur University, Dr. Joya, the professor and head of the Department of Mass Communication and Journalism, and Dr. Anjuman from the same department. I also welcome Rita Banerjee, the director of Green Hub, who is right now connecting from Madhya Pradesh. And I also welcome two of our hub buddies, we call them hub buddies, friends, visitors, one is Pratham and the other person is Deep Jyoti, who are connecting, one from Tejpur, one from Guwahati. And all of them are going to be a part of this journey, as you know, and the conversation as we go ahead. Over to you, Toma, Pramita, and Sucheta.
Good afternoon, everyone. As sir has already said and introduced us, and my name is Sucheta. So, sir has talked about various recipes of wellness very briefly. So, before going into the details of it, we would like all of you to taste one of the ingredients of that recipe, which is Booking Happiness, Wellness Through Children's Book. Now, the key idea is to explore safe spaces through books, having interesting and unique storylines, and getting engaged in fun yet meaningful conversations. So the book that we are going to narrate today, All Are Welcome, will help us in understanding the themes of safe space and community healing and engagement that we are broadly talking here about.
We are going to share the book, screen share it, and also going to read the book aloud. We all wish you hear it, and also keep your ears and eyes open to what are the themes in the book that catches your attention. So yes, I'll share another document here. Just a minute. So for the time being, we are keeping our videos off so that you can concentrate on the book itself. Name of the book is All Are Welcome by Alexandra Benford and Susanne Hoffman. Pencils sharpened in their case, bells are ringing, let's make haste. School's beginning, dreams to chase, all are welcome here. No matter how you start your day, what you wear, when you play, or if you come from far away, all are welcome here. In our classroom, safe and sound, fears are lost, hope is found. Raise your hand, we'll go around. All are welcome here. Gather now, let's all take part. We will play music, we will make art. We will share stories from the heart. All are welcome here. Time for lunch. What a spread! A dozen different kinds of bread. Pass it around till everyone's fed. All are welcome here. Open doors, rush outside. We will swing, we will slide, we will have fun side by side, and all are welcome here. We are part of a community. Our strength is our diversity. A shelter from adversity. All are welcome here.
we will learn from each other. Special talents will uncover. There's a big world to discover. All are welcome here. So much to learn, so much to do. And when the busy day is through, can't wait to come back, start anew. All are welcome here. Head for home to get some rest and greet tomorrow, ready and fresh. Our time together is the best. All are welcome here. You have a place here. You have a space here. You are welcome here.
It was really nice to read this book. I really liked it, and I think both my friends also liked it. So we thought of, and we found this book to be almost telling the story of youth wellness hub. So we went for this book. And and you would love to hear a few words from the panelists and also the attendees, if they have something that resonated with you, something that caught your ears, some words, phrases, pictures, anything. You can put it up in the chat box. And those who are in the panel, always
there is some problem with the audio.
A few chats are popping up, sharing. They're sharing that it brings the memory of school days and the warmth of the book.
And the simplicity, I guess.
Yes.
Another thing that caught my attention was that how simple it was, poem, rhyming, and there's this melody, almost a melody to it, which catches attention.
I think people, all attendees can continue to share your thoughts. We will move forward with our story of youth wellness hub and a bit about how we also find the sense of community and the sense of wellness in our space and what we do to invite them in our space of youth wellness hub. So, to tell you very briefly of what we are trying to do and few of the things you may try in your own life or your own setting where you work, you may discover something very different from what we are doing, or you may find that few of the things we are doing are applicable or good for, or sort of like magical, like Sir was telling, in your work setting. So we will be sharing three spells, what we call three magic spells. One is, we always believe that youth are experts and they have certain knowledge, certain wisdom of how wellness looks like to them, what they can do to invite wellness in their life, and how we have been collaboratively reimagining redefining few of the themes like wellness, how wellness should look like, how the space of wellness should look like. And then how we are, the second thing is how we are breaking the single story of wellness. I'll talk a bit more about that. And lastly, how with the heat of pandemic, how we have adapted ourselves and how we are trying to find the space, the physical space in a virtual platform like Zoom or other spaces, and replicating few of the things, trying to do it. So believing youth are experts and reimagining the youth informed space. So at the very beginning, we didn't have any idea of how the space may look like or should look like. So what we did is we went out to nearby colleges and spoken to the young kids there, young college school students there, about their ideas of wellness, about their ideas of this safe space. We invited them, as you can see in the second picture, a big room and a lot of people are sitting on the floor. It's an old space of youth wellness hub where we invited them. And we again talked more about how the space should look like, even before having decorating or organizing this bungalow. So I was wondering if Pramita and Shuchita can tell what are the knowledges they came with and how we incorporated in our physical space. Are there a few of the things that we really did what they advised us to do?
I think when we talked about space, the thing that came in my mind and also the youth also informed us that the space which doesn't look very formal at the very beginning. So where conversations can take place, when ideas can be exchanged.
Yes.
And when we thought about the space, as you all can see, we are sitting, there are nice lights that are popping up over our head. So all these lights are warm light. So we have the option of keeping the light as warm or as cold. So these small basic things, and I think as...
And also the moras we are sitting.
The moras. And also the sitting arrangement. We thought of that maybe sitting in a circle where we all can see each other whenever we are having a conversation. I think that helped.
Also, some people had come and told that they like the sitting arrangement on floor. Yeah. So we also had kept some sort of carpets so that if they wish, if they feel like, they can also sit on the floor. So and many other small things which may not come in the notice in the first place, but were actually informed by the young people. And not only we talked about it, but we also started documenting it so that things do not get evaporated or do not get lost. So what we call as collective documents, where people sit together and draw something, write something together, and that becomes, as you can see, top of our head, there is one collective document. So that it always reminds us of how to go ahead.
And so one interesting thing about this is that we start with one thing, but the end result becomes something so meaningful and something so different from where we have started. So collective documentation does that as well.
So yeah, it's almost like going for an unplanned trip and never know where we are going and then reaching somewhere to discover something. So yes. And not only we are talking about physical space, but we are talking also about space of conversation. It's not about just the logistics, but what we can do in our behavior attitude so that it can be recognized as a safe space for the young people. What are the things that we keep in mind as we?
So as Taman was already explaining, that not only the physical ambience, but along with it, consideration of how the conversation should be, like some of the ground rules that we follow in our conversations, no shame, no blame, and a non-judgmental stance, and being respectful to whatever others are sharing, and most importantly, that whatever happens in this space or whatever discoveries we make in this space, conversations remain in this space only, but the idea carries on with ourselves in our lives. So that was also another thing important. And along with it, we felt that not only the space, but the conversations are important to make the place and the space inviting and welcoming for the youth so that they can come here and feel safe
as we have been talking since the beginning of the of this webinar, that safe space is something very important, and making this space in every form inviting to the youth is something that we have been considering all throughout.
Right. And although this is almost coming from the key ideas that we read on books, like maintaining confidentiality and thinking about the intention and purpose, the conversations we are trying to co-create,
right,
whoever is coming.
And that is very important, because few of the things people have come and said that we don't want it to share it with anybody else, and then we incorporate it in our ground rules. So the second thing that I was reading was breaking the single story of wellness. So we try to look beyond counseling and therapy, because that is something that we have been doing, and we know that that is something that is definitely useful. But we also, as we had interacted with young people in our clinic, in our hospital, that informed us that all these young people have been doing few of the things in their life, small things to keep themselves well, to soothe themselves, even if they are in the toughest time, in the darkest of their time, possibly making a cup of tea for mother or going for a walk and all those things. So we wanted to make this space available for them, not to just talk about that, but if they can experience that. So as you can see the pictures, these are pictures from different moments where young people had came and, you know, painted a wall in our building, or they had came and sat and just made, like you can see in the left corner, they were using colors to express the emotions they experience from time to time. Or going out for a healing forest walk to be with nature, or something like pottery. So we have made these things available in Wellness Hub so that people can come and experience and see what suits them.
And one another thing which is very important is that it is not only for the people who are coming here as visitors, but also for ourselves.
Exactly.
We also sometimes enjoy the same music. We also participate in the same art workshop. And me, myself, not being a very good painter, when I see that my artwork is also appreciated and it is put up in so many, among so many colorful other paintings, I also feel so much empowered. Feeling of well-being is there, mm-hmm, and a feeling of happiness. Mm-hmm. So not only for visitors, but also for ourselves as professionals, we sometimes forget to care for ourselves. So that is also important.
So I think what Shujita is trying to say, the power of acknowledging something. Yes, and not to see as how good we are at these things, but just to do it because we wish to do it. And that's magical. So as we were doing and trying out many things till pandemic came, and since 2020 February, we were sort of stuck at home at our rooms. So we tried to replicate few of the things online. We knew that not all things will be possible to do it online, but few of the things can definitely be done. So we started doing something called book club. Like we read book, so we did quite a few sessions on book club to see how books can also help us and heal us. As well as we did something called human library. I think sir was sharing a bit about that, where people's stories is shared. People's means people's, like ordinary people like us, their stories and shares are shared, and that create resonance to the other broader people. So we will hear more about that, in fact, as we go ahead. These are very few of the things that we are trying to do for last few years. And now we will hear from some voices who had been helping us by informing us, also had been taking something back from Youth Wellness Hub. So I'll share four voices, actually five voices, and I'll share a video, and I hope you enjoy this. Just a minute.
whole idea of GreenHub is that how can we involve the youth across the Northeast region in conservation action and social change through the use of it?
Sorry, I will share it again.
GreenHub is that how can we involve the youth across the Northeast region in conservation action and social change through the use of video. Every year, 20 fellows are selected from across the Northeast states, mostly from remote areas and marginalized communities. They are with us for 1 year. In this 1 year, they learn how to tell stories through video. And we have several internship partners across the states. Idea is, can you use video as a learning tool? And through that learning, can you be engaged with actual work with communities, actual work with conservation? We do see ecological security as the foundation of a sustainable future, as well as community well-being. While technology has brought in a sense of interconnectedness, it has also led to a world of isolation. Over the last 7 years, in our interaction with indigenous youth across the Northeast region, we've heard of rising incidents of suicides, especially amongst the youth. That has made us think about mental health, of well-being, of what is the reason behind these incidents. We do see nature, our connection with the earth, as a healing space. Is our state of mind connected to the grief of environment loss? Loss of forests, of water, of our hands working with the soil. Youth Wellness Hub is a partnership that has given direction to this exploration of mental health in a more holistic way. It has opened up the dialogue on mental health and well-being for us and the community in multiple ways, in creative ways, like the Yuva Manmeet Festival, which is held every year in Tezpur. We have conducted events and workshops together, integrating our ideas of wellness through art, through photography, through music, through storytelling. For the GreenHub team, for the fellows, for their communities, for our extended network of resource persons and others, Youth Wellness Hub is like a support system. It is a space where we can sit, we can talk, we can share our dilemmas, our thoughts, and resolve our inner conflicts. Youth Wellness Hub and Green Hub are like partners who are helping each other grow, working towards a forest of well-being.
Thank you, Rita ma'am. She has been there with us from the very beginning and informing us what is the need of youth in Tezpur and Northeast. And we have been trying to follow her advices as well as, it's a both way relationship with GreenHub. So we will also hear a few words from Tezpur University Mass Comm Department from Joya ma'am and Anjuman ma'am.
Hello, my name is Anjuman Bora.
I am Joya Chakraborty.
And both of us, we teach at the Department of Mass Communication and Journalism, Tezpur University. For us and for the young students that we work with, Wellness is important for the simple reason that it makes it easier to navigate through the roller coaster journey called life. The Youth Wellness Hub supports us in organizing the orientation program that we do for our newly admitted students. During this process, we make our students conscious about the importance of mental health and wellness in their lives. And we also try to make them aware about the various facilities that are available on the campus for issues related to mental health and wellness, as well as the various facilities that are available beyond the campus for such purposes. We are, after all, a product of the choices that we make. And making a conscious choice to invite wellness into our life can be a life-transforming decision. Youth Wellness Hub also helps us in organizing various workshops for young people from within the Tejpur University campus as well as the different parts of Northeast. During such workshops, we have taken up discussions around mental health, wellness, and the different network of support that we can build around such issues of health and wellness amongst the young people of the region. Especially for young people, the pursuit of wellness can be very important because it can empower them to focus on the positives in spite of the negatives, hold on to hope in spite of the many despairs, enhance their productivity and sense of worth. Our constant engagement with the Youth Wellness Hub has also made us better equipped to deal with and help various young people who are struggling with issues of anxiety and various other mental health problems. We have also become more conscious to their needs, and we are able to provide better support whenever they come to us seeking for any support or any help. In short, deal with life from a position of strength.
Thank you, ma'am and Jaya ma'am. So before we move ahead, we have two of other hub buddies with us, and we will also listen to them. Kindly give us a minute.
Hello, my name is Deep Jyoti, and I'm a doctoral research scholar and a teaching assistant in the Department of Humanities and Social Sciences, IIT Guwahati. Now, when you ask me what does wellness mean to me and to those around me, I have a lot of things in my head, but I do not know what to say. So you understand, it is a very overwhelming thing to think about, and at the same time, it is something which is undermined a lot. By that I mean we do not talk about wellness as much as we should. But after the pandemic, actually I do not know if I can say after the pandemic yet, but yes, with COVID, this entire conversation around mental health, around mental wellness, about emotional well-being, it has resurfaced. And at various levels, at a personal level, at the level of family, at the level of community, at an institutional level, and that is good. We need to talk about wellness more often, and we need to talk about wellness as much as we can. Now, you know, coming to Youth Wellness Hub and my association with Youth Wellness Hub and how Youth Wellness Hub has helped me in my journey of wellness, you know, I would say that Youth Wellness Hub provides me and other young people like me with a land where we can come and cultivate the crop of wellness. Right now, when we talk about agriculture, when we talk about growing something, we cannot do it alone. Right? So agriculture is like life. Growing something is like life. We cannot do it in solitude. So Youth Wellness Hub provides us with people with friends, with a community. And what happens as a result of that? As a result of that, our burdens get shared, right? We divide our responsibilities, we divide our burdens, we help each other. And what happens as a result of that? What happens when we are with each other, holding our hands in this journey of life? It becomes a little less difficult. It becomes a little less alone.
Deepjyoti for sharing your story with us and along with Deepjyoti, who has been the first visitor of UPMS Hub. We have another hub buddy, Pratham, who has also been with us for a very long time throughout our journey in various occasions. So we would like to hear his part of the story as well.
Just give me a moment.
I am Pratham Ghosh and I am currently studying in Dorong College, Tejpur. Wellness is something very important for me. Whenever I am in a dark place, taking care of my wellness has helped me a lot. Small things like writing journals, reading, listening to music, writing poems help me a lot to be on track. I continue to do small things every day to take care of my wellness and to avoid ending up in a dark place. Meditation and connecting to the nature has also helped me a lot to cope with anxiety. I was always a boy who wanted to express myself, and Youth Wellness Hub gave me the platform to express myself through Human Library. It also taught me how the various art forms like poetry, music, etc. can be a medium to attain wellness. When I was first told about the Human Library, I was very excited and agreed to it instantly, hoping that people would take something from my story and learn from it. I narrated my struggles with mental health and suicide and how hope helped me cope with it. It was a great experience for me because I saw people listening to my story and resonating with it. This event made me realize that although our stories may be different, but it is connected by a common thread, hope.
To all four of these people because they took time out of their busy schedule and did this for us, and also for remaining connected with Youth Wellness Hub for such a long time and informing us. So I was thinking that although we have seen them in the video for brief moments for two persons, if we can have all of them back for maybe two or three minutes to have a live discussion with them. Will that be possible for all four of you? All five of you?
Yes, sure, Toma.
yes from us.
Pratham Dipjyoti.
Yeah, sure.
Pratham, you there?
Yes, sure.
Okay. So it was really nice to hear what wellness means for you and what Hub has been doing to sort of nurturing the wellness for your life. We were just wondering about one thing. I mean, not one thing, but more. But for now, for the time being, just one thing is what might become possible if. Just give me a moment. What may become possible or visible if such kind of space like Youth Wellness Hub are co-created with youth and made accessible to every youth of the country? What if it becomes accessible to every youth in the country? What might become possible? Maybe very briefly from all five of you.
Can I ask Dr. Rita Banerjee to initiate?
Yes.
Thanks for making me a doctor. I'm very happy to do that, but I'm not. But I don't mind at all. It adds to my wellness for sure. So, I think we have seen what a difference Youth Wellness Hub has made for the entire community in Tezpur, and not just Tezpur, but if I look at GreenUp, for the entire community of youth across the Northeast, because we have youth from across all the states. So Youth Wellness Hub has created that hub or a support system for an entire network. So definitely if something like this goes to each and every corner of the country or becomes part of every community, I think it will make a huge impact, and especially for youth who I feel are currently going through a lot of ups and downs with so many things happening around them, whether it's technology, whether it's environment, whether it's aspirations. So I feel it's a very important move, you know.
Joya Chakraborty.
Hello, and thank you for having us here. And we really cherish this bonding that we have with the Youth Wellness Hub. It has been a very, very enriching experience for us in various ways. And we really see the potential of a facility like this. And if it becomes accessible, or this sort of a safe space for discussion becomes accessible for each and every young person who is there, because young people, they are the future of our nation. And constantly we see when we are interacting with the different students, again, coming from the whole of the country, they come to us from different parts of the country, and we see the type of struggle that they are going through, and on various occasions, not able to articulate it, not knowing in front of whom to articulate, what to articulate, and whether to articulate at all or not. So they're constantly negotiating with all of these anxieties and probably just suffering alone. So this network of support, and we have been having a constant discussion around this of the concept of Adda that Dr. Dipdurup was just mentioning a little while back, that if we could create such spaces, and we really look forward to this partnership that we are having with the Youth Wellness Hub and trying to take it forward as much as possible, and really see a future where no young person would probably be giving up hope, will probably be stopping to expect positives from life, and would want to forge ahead and realize the full potential that they have and contribute to the growth of the country, which obviously they have a lot of scope to do. So really a great initiative, if even through the app that we are talking about now, if it's possible. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Briefly, I would like to hear from Pratham and Dipjyoti next.
Maybe Dipjyoti can start.
Okay, hi. Yeah, with the kind of space that Youth Wellness Hub has created, you know, I remember in one of the meetings, so one person had said, she had said that when she started coming to the hub, she was a very introvert, you know, she was introvert and she did not want to talk to people. She was not comfortable. And, you know, she was not really speaking in those meets. You know, she also visited you physically and she also joined in the virtual meeting. So she was not really comfortable to speak, but, you know, she was listening. And through that act of listening, you know, the stories that she got to listen, she actually felt better. So these kind of spaces, they do not only create a space for people to come and speak, but also to come and listen and just be. And I believe that is important. You know, spaces like Youth Wellness Hub, they have great potential. Here we collect stories, here we spin stories and mend what we can, we investigate what we cannot, and we, you know, try to strive, you know, we strive to change the world through stories, where stories are also, you know, they have the added responsibility of healing. That's what I have to say. Over to you, Pratham.
Yes, I think it would be great to, you know, have such kind of spaces all over the country, because I see my friends struggle every day. They often struggle with things, but they don't know where to go, how to communicate. And I think these kind of spaces will give them, you know, a platform to express themselves, and also they can go and they wouldn't be judged for what they say, and also get a positive feedback. So that's all for me.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for being a part of this webinar today. And before we move forward, I would just like to highlight why we chose, you know, to present this videos and audio clips and invite the Green Hub, Jaya Chakravarti from Tejpur University, and these buddies, hub buddies, is because, see, we have been listening to wellness webinars, lectures. Mostly these webinars, we found that they talk about theories, right? But we wanted to showcase things which have already been done and how it is being done. That is the reason why we brought this up today, so that it can be, you know, adopted by other institutes, by other organizations. And then we provide a platform for all the youths of our country for a better India tomorrow. That is the whole idea behind presenting this. Now, there are multiple ways. It cannot be discussed in one webinar. The work of for the past 3 to 4 years, you know, so many hurdles have to be passed over, so many approvals, so many planning. There are many things that need to be done. And today we are at this stage. So there are many other ways which we can discuss later on of how things can be done, how to create such a space, and how to motivate youth, you know, to have their own wellness. With that, I think I will not take question and answer because of time limits. Deepthorup, I ask you to take it forward from here.
Thank you. Thank you, Vijay, for giving me this opportunity to say the last word, as if the last word are the final words and the most important one. But as I've been telling, it's a journey. It's the spices of life that you go on adding and tasting whether it is tasting good and how could we make it better. So it's a journey.
But before we go ahead, can I ask Dr. Ketaki Bapat, Dr. Sudarshan,
yes,
Lakshmanan, if they are already here? I think they are here to have their inputs.
First of all, thank you so much for such wonderful sharing of information, data on various apps, and beautiful videos which can really touch people, starting from the childhood and up to different ages. Thank you so much for the various contributors. One thing again, what I would submit is that we, all of us who are in different positions working for promoting mental health, has a responsibility that we should address the social stigma associated with mental health as well. I'm hopeful with all our cooperated effort, we should be successful in dealing with this. And all the very best to LGBRIMH Mental Health Institute, because these steps which you have initiated is definitely going to help us in a long way. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, sir, for your beautiful comments and encouraging comments. Thank you. Dr. Ketiki, madam, are you there? Dr. Sudarshan? I think they are not yet here. So, okay, Dipturup. Dr. Sudarshan is here.
Yes. So, thank you, sir. Actually, Dr. Gavi and the entire team, you know, coordinated by Professor Deep Tarup and the Youth Wellness Hub. The entire thing, actually, we were watching. I had a couple of more people listening to the entire process. So maybe, no, this is a nice way. This can also become one of the modules. How to engage and how to create this culture of communicating with peers. And so that will be a very nice thing. So really happy with the way today things went on. And Tejpur, like Madam already told, we are actually very Tej in all aspects. And we look forward to collaborating, and some of your components can be made part of the offering on the platform, so that you know you can reach way beyond Tejpur and you can be digitally omnipresent.
Thank you, sir.
So thank you so much. Namaste, and thank you to all the participants.
Dr. Ketiki Bapat. Madam, are you there? Okay, Dipturup, kindly provide a vote of thanks.
Thank you. I'm really honored and thankful to be a part of such a wonderful afternoon. It's a different kind of afternoon for us, typically engaged in our classrooms, lectures, hospitals, clinics. And this wonderful afternoon had been possible because of our seniors, the dignitaries of today's program. And I'd like to communicate our heartfelt thanks to our director, Sir Professor S.K. Deuri. He has been providing us the push and support. And it's an experiment, Hub being an experiment. It requires courageous funders and supporters and mentors. Sir had been that. We are extremely thankful to the guidance and the opportunity provided to us today by the dignitaries. I especially would like to mention Dr. Ketiki Bapat, Dr. Sudarshan, Dr. Atre Ganguly, and Dr. Lakshmanan, who had also honored us by being the dignitaries and shared their inputs and also their wish list. And we hope that we learn together and add to what we can collectively do and take things forward. I'm also very thankful to C-DAC, especially Sukeshini Ji, for coordinating the whole program and having prior meetings so that things go smooth. I'm also very thankful to Green Hub, Tejpur University, Rita, Joya, Anjuman, Pratham and Deep Jyoti for connecting and for having the courage to share the platform and sharing openly their stories, however brief that it be. And it's not an easy thing. So I'm really, really thankful to both of you, Pratham and Deep Jyoti. I have to say formal thank you, I say that you are my gurus, my team members. Right now, you could see three of them, Toma, Pramita, and Sucheta. A huge round of applause for three of you to not only having this program done, but also holding the hub together for the last 3-4 years. I'm thankful to Dr. Vijay and Meet LGBRIMH for helping us, nudging us, being courageous and venture into the difficult and unknown virtual world. And with baby steps, we have been able to do that. And our first encounter with virtual world started even before the pandemic with the courses offered by NEET for people, for professionals in Northeast and other parts, which we still continue to run with more vigor. We will be doing that. I am also thankful to people behind the scene, Dr. Tejas, with Dr. Vijay in the Meet LGBRMH behind the camera. But if you could just show your face for a moment, as we have been inviting our panelists to be there. I'm so thankful creating the nice flyer. And I think 9th version of it was what was satisfactory to all of us. Thank you. Thank you, Tejas, for being with us. I'm also thankful to all the office staff of all the departments, academic departments, and office staff of clinical psychology, especially the hub, Mr. Ainul Haq being one person that you'd like to mention. I would also like to mention entire staff of administration and the officials of the administration who has provided us the go-ahead and the courage and the approval needed for doing that. And finally, how could we forget about the soil that Deepjyoti was mentioning, the farming done on the soil that is our own institute, LGBRMH, for supporting us, both Meet the Digital Academy and Youth Wellness Hub in our initiative to, yes. And I should also not forget something, people who are behind the scene are always forgotten. So Rahul, would you please come in front of the camera, if possible, whichever the closest camera that you have. So thank you all for being with us and having spent this afternoon. We overshot the time by 10 minutes. Sorry for that. And we hope that we meet again. But before I say goodbye, I go back to Dr. Vijay for any last comment.
Thank you, Deeptaru. And I thank all the dignitaries and all the participants who have attended this webinar live with us, and those who are watching YouTube live or, you know, participated in this webinar but not on the panel list. Thank you, everyone, for being a part of here of it today. And we wish to have more such webinars and create a better world for tomorrow. Thank you, everyone, and have a good evening.